I haven't made a Final Cut Pro tutorial in a while. I want to change that today. Today I want to show you how you can easily create cool transitions for your videos with the help of masks. My name is Werner, I live in the Italian Alps, and this channel is about filmmaking tutorials and reviews of consumer cameras. If you're interested in these topics, consider subscribing to the channel and have fun with this video. Fancy transitions like zoom effects look cool, but have been criticized a lot lately, because they have been used too often and in an inappropriate way. Transitions with a mask effect are still used today by many creators, especially in travel videos. They are easy to create and don't look completely unnatural when used in the right way. There are several ways to use masks for transitions. I would like to show you two possible examples today. If, by the way, you're interested in what camera or other equipment I use, then have a look at the links in the video description. A mask should basically do exactly what the word suggests. It should hide something. When you apply a mask to a clip, you can only see the part of the clip that is inside the mask. Everything outside the mask becomes transparent. It will then look black, or you will see for this area the clip that is in the track below. If you invert the mask, it's the other way around. You will only see the parts of your clip which are outside the mask. For the parts inside the mask, you will see the clip in the track below, or the area remains black if there is no clip in the track below. To use the mask effect in Final Cut Pro, select Masks under Effects. Now you can choose from 5 different types of masks. To create a transition, I use either a shape mask or a draw mask. So that you can see both, I will create the first transition with a shape mask and the second with a draw mask. For the first example, I will use a clip of this lake. I planned for a later transition when I shot it. As you can see here, I moved the camera in front of this bar from top to bottom. The bar moves through the frame. This movement and the bar will now be used to introduce another clip, the close-up of this leaf. Both clips show the lake and fit well together. The transition will not appear unnatural. I now choose a shape mask. As you can see, you can draw shapes relatively quickly. With curvature, you can make the shape rounder or more angular. With feather, you can adjust the area at the edges where the effect slowly fades out towards the inner or outer side. You can also use falloff to determine how sharp the edges should look. With invert, you can invert the effect of the mask. For this transition, the mask should reveal the underlying clip, so we click on invert. I now enlarge the mask so that the whole clip fits easily. At the end, the mask has to cover the whole clip and make it transparent. Now I pull it to the outside and move to the start of the clip. And now move frame by frame to the moment where the bar is completely in the frame. This is where our transition starts, at the bottom left. Now we have found our starting position. The important thing now is that you activate the keyframes under position and rotation. This way the mask will move later when you change its position. Now I continue frame by frame and adjust the rotation and position of the mask. Each time you make a change, Final Cut Pro automatically creates a new keyframe. As you can see here, the shape mask is only suitable because the bar is straight. Once the bar is out of the frame, everything should be black or transparent. Let's have a quick look at the effect in the magnification. I now check if the edges are clean. As you can see, the effect already looks relatively good. Now all we have to do is to put the appropriate clip in the track below and the transition is done. In order to make the transition work and look natural, you should make sure that both clips have a similar exposure. After this first example, I would like to show you another possible way to use the masking effect for a transition. Basically, there are no limits for your imagination. The second example will be a bit more challenging. I want to cut out the side mirror of the car and use it for a transition into the next clip. The difficulty is that I didn't move the camera in a straight line towards the mirror. The mirror also has no straight edges. Getting this effect clean becomes a challenge. I move to the position of the clip where the mirror is as large as possible and add a draw mask. Like before, I use invert mask. Under shape type, I set B-spline. This way you can draw not only straight lines but also rounded lines. If you have added at least 3 points, you can draw a curve using the point in the middle. I now try to reproduce the shape of the mirror as precisely as possible. I think it should work that way. Before I adjust my mask to the movements of the clip, I activate the keyframes for scale, position and rotation. Now I move frame by frame and adjust my mask. If it is sufficient, I only use scale. Only if this is not sufficient, I also adjust the position and rotation. I will not change the individual points of the mask. That would look strange later on. As you can see, the whole process can be very time consuming. When I'm done and satisfied with it, I put a clip in the track below. I don't like two things here yet: exposure and blur. The first clip is darker and at the beginning of the clip the mirror is not in focus. For this reason, I darken the second clip a bit and add some blur. For this I use the Gaussian blur effect. With the help of keyframes, I reduce the blur effect when I come closer with the camera. And that would also complete our second transition. I think it looks pretty good. And that's it for today. If the video was interesting for you, give me a like as feedback and see you next time.